Giving up, Austin police have been conducting stings to crack down on Uber and Lyft drivers in town, going undercover to catch these folks, and giving out about 140 citations so far. Just as the same time this week, the Austin City Council will consider a measure to allow Uber and Lyft to operate in town. Seems like a conflict of interest,
yeah,
doesn't it?
There's a city working together in perfect cohesion.
Well, the city has a contract with these cab companies. So the city has to honor that contract or you will be sued by these cab companies. That's the next shoe to drop right there. Uber and Lyft have been out there on the streets for a few months now in Austin. Basically, it's one of those ride-sharing applications where you log on to with your smartphone and somebody comes and picks you up and you pay them just like you might pay a cab.
Sure.
But the cabbies are very upset with this. And a proposal is being presented this week at Austin City Hall to allow these cab companies to operate. Here's Rudy Koski from Fox 7 News.
So I'm proposing a way to legalize services like Uber and Lyft now through operating agreements.
The plan targets drivers like Anthony Wynn.
You Jason? Okay.
He started picking up people in his own vehicle after learning about the service during a recent West Coast visit. But each rider comes with the risk of a fine and having his SUV impounded.
You feel a little bit like you are an outlaw doing this, but I don't necessarily. I feel like it's a new movement. It's the way that the transportation industry is going.
Wynn was among those who came to City Hall Monday to support Councilman Riley's effort to make rideshare companies register with the city. Key points include showing proof of insurance, criminal and driving background checks, vehicle safety inspections, and improved price disclosures. The councilman admitted his idea is a work in progress.
This doesn't purport to be a permanent solution, but this does attempt to address the situation that is on the ground today.
Yeah, Anthony Wynn, who's mentioned in that story with Rudy Koski of Fox 7 News, he actually got a citation last night. He was busted by one of those undercover police officers. He says it was four officers and a couple of city employees in a tow truck. They actually towed his vehicle away, gave him a citation. He thought it might happen because he got in contact with someone who needed a ride to the Hooters downtown.
Which is famous for where they do the stings.
It's what the rumor has been in cyberspace, that's what they were doing, is catching rides to Hooters, and then they would give them a citation and possibly even take their vehicle.
But apparently Lyft was very quick to reimburse him to get his car out and also to provide a lawyer. So they were on it. What I don't understand, you say that the city has contracts with these companies. Why would the city set up contracts with something that is running illegally? Why would we do that?
The city does not have contracts with Lyft and Uber.
You just said they did.
No, they have contracts with the cab companies.
Okay, well, let's be very clear, because you're also referring to Uber and Lyft as cabs.
They're cab-like. Okay. They compete with cab companies.
That's what I was confused about. But why isn't the city, nonetheless, our city council is not working with the police department? Why are they at odds on this? The police department's doing a sting while our city council is trying to get this pushed through.
Well, the police department is just enforcing the laws that are on the books.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
So shouldn't our city council be behind that as well?
They should be, yeah. They're the ones that made the rules.
This does not instill a lot of confidence, not that I had any to begin with in our
city. It just seems like a big waste of time and resources for this number of cops to be out there trying to catch Uber drivers. Now, part of the problem is, according to Sheldon Levin, he's in the limo business here in town. He says Uber and Lyft are dangerous.
People have actually died as a result of these organizations and lack of safety. When you fast-track something, that's not the Austin way. As an organization, support this. We embrace it. We want the competition. But we want a level playing field, and I'm not talking monetarily. I'm talking from a safety issue.
There you go. Jump in on the conversation at 512-836-0590, the Todd and Don Show.
APD conducted a pretty big operation targeting Uber and Lyft drivers, giving out tickets. And in one case we talked about, the driver's car was even impounded. So do you use Uber? Do you think it's a good thing for Austin? It's illegal, by the way.
What say you?
Todd, I think any kind of competition is good. I think ultimately this is going to be a great thing if it's done above board. If everybody gets the proper permits, the proper insurance that they got to have. You know, they have to have commercial driver's insurance as well to do that. So that's all I care about. Just make it safe, and I think it's a great deal.
Here are the phone numbers, 512-836-0590, toll-free 877-590-5525. Also in the news, combined U.S.-Arab airstrikes hit Islamic State military strongholds in Pflugerville on the Tata Don Show.
Hey, guys. I heard you guys talking about my story, but I am the guy that, was impounded.
Anthony Nguyen, you're the Uber driver that's mentioned in the news today. Interesting. Tell us what happened. You got a citation, and did they impound your vehicle?
Yeah.
Tell you, start from the very beginning. What happened?
Yeah, so I just dropped off somebody, a girl at the Serrano's on Red River, and got a Lyft request from a Jennifer, no picture, at the Sheraton. And I went to go pick her up, and she was there with another gentleman, and they were going to Hooters. So I was a little bit suspicious because I was on the Facebook group, and I heard that another gentleman that was impounded a month earlier picked up two African-American males going to Hooters.
So you knew there was a possibility that you could be busted in this state. Up.
Yeah. So I asked him some simple questions like, oh, you guys staying at the Sheraton? And the gentleman was like, yeah. And he kind of hesitated.
Bad actors.
And, yeah. So I continue asking, oh, where are you guys from? And he's like, Houston. And very flippant about it. But, you know, I just went through it, and I drove down 6th Street, down Guadalupe Street.
Yep.
And went into Hooters, pulled into Hooters, and the gentleman tried to give me, I think, like $7 cash. Mm-hmm. And I said, no, I can't take that. It's, you know, all done through the app. There's a donation. And then he asked me to end the ride, which is kind of a technical term in the industry. Mm-hmm. And it was unusual that he would ask that. But I did end the ride. And then he acted like he didn't know what he was doing. He said, oh, okay, here it is. Then I saw the APD officer pull up behind me. As soon as they opened the door and walked out, the lights went flashing.
Yeah.
And the APD officer came up to me and asked if I knew why I was being stopped. I said no. Asked if I had a chauffeur's permit. I said no. Mm-hmm. And then from there, he said that what I was doing was illegal. I asked him, what was I doing? And he said Lyft. Like, Lyft is illegal, but Lyft is just an app for finding passengers and setting up transactions, just like eBay. You post up on eBay, they handle the transaction. You know, it's not like we work for eBay, and we don't work for Lyft. They are a matching service like Google or Bing, and they just happen to find us.
This is pretty ironic because you were there at that press conference supporting Chris Riley in his measure to basically regulate these ride-sharing apps. It's pretty ironic that you're there with the city councilman trying to get this on the, you know, make it legal, make it legitimate, that, you know, that sort of thing, but you got busted.
Yeah, it was. I was there a week ago, and then 5 days later, I was busted. So Fox had asked me if they thought I was targeted. I don't think personally targeted, because there's no way that they know who I am. I mean, they know my car, I guess, but it would be pretty tough for them unless they were following me around. I think if anything, I think maybe the taxi industry, it has some kind of connection with the city to continue the sting operation. APD is totally against it. They have a court order that they have to follow. And they, if you saw my dash cam videos talking to them, they were very apologetic, but they have to enforce the laws, and I understand that.
That's understandable. They're there to enforce the laws. What time of day was this?
This was 8:45 at night.
At night, on a Friday night, when they could be out there catching drunk drivers. You know what I mean?
Exactly.
I mean, it seems like overkill. How many city employees dealt with you?
It was a total of 7 personnel.
God.
2 undercover officers.
So 2 hypocritical.
APD officers,
wow.
And then there's 2 city workers. There's one guy, you see him in the dash cam writing a ticket, and then there's another city worker taking videos of my car.
Wow.
And then the impound guy. Fighting crime.
Well, so if you did have a chauffeur's license, would you have still gotten a ticket?
I don't believe so, but I can't get a chauffeur's permit.
Why not?
Because you need a sponsor. And since we don't work for Lyft or Uber, they wouldn't sponsor us. They are not licensed taxis. We can't hail people. They're just a search engine. They're an app that finds customers. So we're independent contractors. So
okay, but Lyft was, but you don't work for them. But Lyft still was very quick to, if the story was correct, that they got your car back for you.
They reimbursed him, I think.
And they also provided a lawyer.
Yeah. I paid for it with my credit card because it was 9 o'clock at night. I called them. They said nobody was available, but I just paid the $171. And then on Saturday, they contacted me. I sent a copy of the citation and the receipt, and they did a Chase Quick Pay, and I had that money like at 12 o'clock on Saturday. And they assigned a lawyer. The lawyer just called me this morning. She saw the news story also, and she's going to take care of the citation part of it going forward, so I don't even have to show up.
But Lyft, they weren't obligated to do that, right, since you don't technically work for them?
Right. They weren't obligated to do that, but it's been their policy that if if it happens and you're using their app and, they have their customer on record, that they will pay all fines, all impoundments.
Yeah, they're not obligated to do it, but it is in their best interest to make this work. They want them. I mean, they're two companies that want to get it going. But what's ironic about this whole thing, Anthony, is the police chief, the city council, everybody talks about this drunk driving culture that we have in town and getting more options for people to get home. Lyft and Uber are legitimate options for people to get home safely. I'd rather be in your car than one of these stinky, smelly cabs.
I agree.
And we've heard many stories, Anthony, where at 2 o'clock in the morning, it's hard to get a cab because they don't want to pick them up.
You're absolutely right. And I've heard countless stories of the same situation where cabs, they pick and choose. They crack down their windows. They ask where you're going. If it's not long enough or the wrong side of town, they move on. And that's illegal.
You're right.
But because they've had a monopoly for so long, they've been able to do that because, they know that they're the only game in town. They've just become too arrogant in Austin.
It's become a monopoly is what it's become, and public safety is at risk. Hey, Anthony, man, I appreciate you talking to us. Thanks a lot for calling in. Anthony Nguyen, he's an Uber or Lyft driver. I'm not sure. Was he Lyft driver? He's a Lyft driver.
Lyft. Yep.
And recently got busted by Austin police. 512-836-0590. The Todd and Don Show. Austin City Councilman Chris Riley has a proposal on the table for the next city council meeting. That's Thursday. He wants to allow Uber and Lyft and other ride-sharing applications to actually do business here in town. Cabbies don't like that idea. Limousine drivers don't like that idea. But just as they're doing this, moving forward with the possibility of allowing them to operate in town, Austin police have been going undercover in a team of officers undercover, seven at a time, to basically impound cars and issue citations for Lyft and Uber drivers. We heard from Anthony Nguyen just a moment ago before the news. He was the one mentioned all morning long. He was busted. He took a group of undercover cops to the Hooters downtown, got a citation. He was pulled over by a police officer, and they took his car away.
So if the city wants this so badly, why are they not speaking out about all of these drivers doing what they need to do as far as proper insurance, proper permitting, all that, above board? Do what you got to do.
That's what Chris Riley wants to do.
Well, then I don't hear him saying that.
Chris Riley has a proposal. We had a press conference last week about it, and there will be some guidelines, some specific guidelines that folks would have to follow.
You're not listening.
Ultimately, the cabbies, the taxi business, this would be good for them as far as trying to up their game, trying to make them more available, make their prices a little bit more competitive. It's good for everybody.
Alex at Lake Travis on the Todd and Don Show.
Good morning. I talked this morning about this a little. I have been part of getting ordinances together both in San Francisco, Houston, New York. Houston right now, past August 4th, has the most stringent TNC ordinance out there. The problem here is politics. Any of the Uber drivers and Lyft drivers calling in that claim the $1 million insurance, this is the standard Lyft and Uber mantra. Ask any of them, have you seen the actual policy, and is your name and or entity a loss payee? They will tell you unequivocally, no. If you Google Herrera versus Uber, currently going through the San Francisco District Court, you will see what happens when an Uber car gets involved in an accident. Suddenly, this general liability insurance that they're claiming covers you as a loss payee evaporates. And that's the problem. Anytime there's a problem with Uber, surge pricing, anything else, they suddenly become an app. But when challenged, or God forbid that someone's in their way, they become an advocate. And that's the problem.
Yeah.
We're not, all we're asking for is transparency and safety. And
are
my
you,
whole.
In regards to transparency, are you a cab driver?
No, I'm not.
What is your stake in this?
What is my stake? I represent several organizations, not only Americans with Disability, National Limousine Association, the CTLA.
All right, so you're a lawyer and you represent various groups that...
I'm not a lawyer, no. Call me an activist, media strategist, whatever you want.
Okay. We're just trying to figure out. Go ahead.
Oh, no. I don't want to... We'll talk about transparent. I want you to know where I'm coming from, and I do not want TNCs to go away. I think this is the wave of the future. But problem is... The TNCs are anything but transparent. And when you have politics involved, Austin is about write a temporary order that gives the most lax or lack of control in the entire country. And to claim that they don't have the ability to get an ordinance, Houston has a 26-page ordinance just past August 4th that is good to go, ready to go. And that's my challenge to Councilman Riley. And this Uber, this amendment coming up on Thursday is not written by Riley. It's written by Uber and Lyft. Mm-hmm. And so the question is, where is the money? We always follow the money. That's what I want to know.
But you say this is the wave of the future. It's going to happen.
Sure.
And your belief is that we need to get our ducks in a row and do it right.
That's my whole point. Imagine if when Jim Bob Moffat came to town and we told Save Our Springs, you know what? It's good for development. It's great for Austin. Let's just forego if we don't have the enforcement to worry about it. Let's just forego that for a while while we do it. And, you know, someone actually died in San Francisco because an Uber driver was using his app. It's on the web now. You can look at it.
I know what you're talking about. That's true. That did happen, yeah.
Exactly. Yeah. That's my whole point. I want pragmatism here. I'm not trying to blame out and say Uber drivers are bad and all of that.
No,
they're just misinformed. That's all I'm saying.
Good point, Alex. Thank
you,
man.
Absolutely.
Appreciate that.
Absolutely.
That's a fair assessment.
And the thing is, in a town like Austin, Texas, which is so tech-savvy and so hipster-friendly, hipsters love this. They do, because it all has to do with an app. It is just, the bottom line, it's way cooler to call Uber or, I'm sorry, not even call, to press the button to get Uber or Lyft. It's just a hipper thing to do, and Austin's going to wrap its arm around it. So make this right, and then go nuts.
Hannah is in Central Austin. Hannah?
Hi. I am a yellow cab driver. I've been driving for almost 28 years. I'm an owner-operator. I'm involved in this battle, and it is about fairness and transparency, as that previous guy pointed out. What I'm seeing in Riley's proposal is, well, you know, we'll let Uber and Lyft and other such companies just, you know, we'll let them regulate themselves. Well, I'm sorry, but if the cab companies have to have their policies on file with the city so that you could trot down to the transportation office right now and see what a cab customer is covered for in an accident, they should too. If I have to pay a dollar to pick up at the airport, they should too. If I have to pay ad valorem tax because I'm using my vehicle, my own vehicle, for business in the city of Austin, in Travis County, they should too. If I have to trot my butt down to the DPS in the transportation office every 2 years in order to present my criminal history and my driving record, which is not available on Google, they should too.
What we've been told by Lyft and Uber drivers, they are checked monthly for that kind of thing.
You know, you ask them if they've had to go to the DPS and get a copy of their criminal record. Ask them and their driving record. Ask them if they've had to show it to the city.
Let me ask you this, Hannah. What kind of vehicle do you drive out there when you're a taxi driver?
Right now, I'm driving a 2008 Ford Escape Hybrid. Mm-hmm. This weekend, I will be purchasing a Ford C-Max Hybrid, brand new, because this car is ready to be retired. But I can't make it a taxi or run it commercially until, and this is the other point, until I have paid off the car to the lender, because they will not lend you money to buy a car as an individual in order for it to be used commercially.
Let me ask you this,
Hannah. So all of these people who are using their cars and still owe money on it are lying to their investors and to their lenders. Some of these people are renting cars from Avis. Avis, the car rental industry, has already checked in on this issue. They're not telling the people at Avis that they're using their cars commercially.
Hannah, the cab companies have taken a lot of criticism this morning for not picking up people at 2 o'clock in the morning when they need a ride the most. Have you seen that happen?
First of all, the people who are using the app are the same people who just spent overnight camped outside an Apple store in order to get the latest Apple toy.
Yes.
And so they want a cab to be there within 10 seconds of when they call one. Mm-hmm. We do have to balance out the fact that those of us in the cab business are actually doing this full time to earn a living, not to supplement our income or do anything like that. This is how we earn our living.
Right.
So the other thing is, the industry has made several proposals of ways that we could increase the number of vehicles that are available at certain critical times, such as during ACL and, you know, big events like that.
Sure.
And the city has expressed absolutely no interest in that at all.
Well, it sounds to me like the city does not want to renegotiate any kind of contractual terms with the cab companies. And if you think about it, the city's kind of been in violation with the current contract the city has with you. So it sounds to me like this could be in court eventually.
We are negotiating. A task force was set up in May with 180 days to report back to the city.
Do you think this is going to end up in court?
180 days has not passed yet, and yet Riley's trying to short circuit all the discussions and then the negotiation about all of this.
Do you think this will end up in court?
Absolutely, because if they do not have equal regulation for doing exactly what we're doing, just because they have an app, that's kind of like saying in 1904, we're not a cab company because we have telephones or we have horseless carriages. So what?
Is there
doing what we're doing?
Any talk in your industry to catch up with the times and create your own app?
Oh my goodness, where have you been? Look up Hail a Cab app. That's Yellow Cab's app. You can order a cab with the Yellow Cab app right now.
Well, it's not very popular. That's my point. It doesn't sound like it's being utilized as much as Uber and Lyft. I mean, to remain competitive, you got to keep up with the times.
Well, you know, that's an issue of PR, maybe.
Yeah.
And the other thing is, here's the other thing that's so wrong about this. What if you're a little old lady who doesn't have a smartphone? What if you live in the project and you don't have a credit card? Is Uber going to be picking up poor people at the laundromat, taking them home to the project? No, they're not interested in that.
No, I agree with you on that front. I agree with you on that. Uber and Lyft are actually setting themselves up for lawsuits, discrimination lawsuits, specifically against, you know, from the disabled community.
Right, it's not.
You know, they're not equipped to pick up someone in a wheelchair.
The disabled, the elderly.
Yeah, exactly. Hannah, thank you. I appreciate it, man. Thank you for being out there on the front lines in the cab business. 512-836-0590, the Todd and Don Show. Back to the phones. Is it Diane in Westlake on the Todd and Don Show? Hey, Diane.
Hi, good morning.
Good morning.
I've been listening, and I just learned about Lyft, about a month ago when I was visiting. I was at a bridal shower in California. A couple of things. First of all, independent contractors are real estate agents. They drive passengers in their car. They have to put what is called a rider to their insurance policy on it, so this insurance issue can be solved. A couple of the young girls that are drivers at this bridal shower I went to, I was totally impressed. They... Basically, one had earned enough money to cover her textbooks for medical school. They do it part-time. I think they're very entrepreneurial. My husband takes a taxi probably 4 to 6 times a month to the airport. That's not going to change. He's going to continue taking the taxi.
Sure.
But I have 2 adult sons, and they tell me when they're downtown, and I hate to admit it, but they need a taxi, one's not to be found.
Yeah. You're spot on, Diane. The reason this is such a controversy and a problem is because of the cab companies themselves.
I know
They have developed a bad reputation over the past few years of being stinky, smelly, not available.
Worst.
And if they would have been keeping up with the times, then this wouldn't be. If they were competitive and pleasing their customers at a better rate, then the competition wouldn't even try to get into the business.
Again, and availability.
Yeah.
Availability. They're not there. My kids need them. They're not there. My husband, he has his taxi guy who comes and picks him up, and that's all great, though I think it could be a little cleaner. But, you know, there's room for all, and we just have to get off our high horse. It works in other cities. Let it be in this city as well, because we sure need it.
The business,
hypocritical and say we have a problem with drunk driving and we don't solve it.
The business is changing, and those that will survive will be the ones that provide the best service for the best price.
Yeah, but you were talking to the cab driver earlier there who said, where have you been? We have an app. But the problem with the taxi business with Yellow Cab and the others, there's no hip factor to it. To compete with Uber, which is very hip, it's very young.
Get cool.
They're going to have to get cool. And how they're going to do that, and that's just the way marketing works. They're going to have to get cool and compete with that. But one of my problems with Uber and Lyft, here's what I don't understand, and maybe you know this, Todd. What is the requirement of the driver? I'm sure, please tell me that there's an extensive background check on the drivers as far as the
both
record.
Both of those companies do background checks.
Okay, but beyond that, is there any kind of test? Does anybody with Uber or Lyft sit with the driver just to make sure that they can drive worth a darn?
Last week when we talked about this, we had a guy call in, and Lyft does come out and inspect the vehicle more than a state inspection.
But do they inspect the driver?
They have a driver's license, and they have auto insurance.
That doesn't mean a thing to me. They've already been inspected
by the state.
That doesn't mean a thing to me. Because
have you been inspected?
No.
You're driving on the same road, possibly with passengers.
And I'm not saying I'm the greatest driver. You've ridden with me.
You're a horrible driver.
Okay. I can own that. But I'm a safe driver.
No, you're not.
Well, okay, whatever. But anyway, just because they have a driver's license, just because they have insurance, all the stuff does not mean they should be on the damn road, because we wait 8 years between the times we get another driver's license.
How many times have you been cut off by a cabbie downtown?
Not many.
But you have, right? You've seen bad cab drivers. Come on.
Sure, they're out there. But I'm saying it's got to be a little tighter for me to really get behind this as far as what their requirements are.
You can explain what a little tighter means. Rick, on the Todd and Don Show.
You know what it means.
Mike, way to go, gentlemen. Keep that ball rolling.
Yeah,
do what we can.
Well, actually, Don, to kind of address your question, one of the reasons Uber is so popular is because the drivers themselves are being rated by their actual customers. When you call them up and you get to, you know, pick your driver, and they got a list of reviews from, I mean, you can't do that with a taxi.
No.
I mean.
They wouldn't even adventure into that field.
Of course not.
They would not do
that's
that.
Problem.
Yeah.
For that lady who worked for the you guys laid it out very well just now about the competition. If they were doing a good job, none of the rest of this would be happening. The Uber and these guys are filling the need because there's a need there because the cab companies are not filling it.
And we just have and one of the biggest elements of this is plain and simple: Uber and Lyft is cheaper. It's a lot cheaper than taking a cab.
Well, sometimes the prices do change unexpectedly, so some folks have been shocked. Getting a bill that's 3 times as much as a cab because they used Uber and Lyft. We had some stories yesterday afternoon from some folks that have used both, and they have been shocked by the unexpected increase in the price, almost three times as much in some cases, depending on the time of day and the location. Carlos, downtown on the Todd and Don Show.
Hey, guys. I'm a Iraqi veteran, a military police, and a Lyft driver, so I have perspective on both, if you let me really quick. Finally, Obama is doing something. Finally, he's dropping bombs, and I'm surprised. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No, go ahead. We only got about 20 seconds. Go.
Okay. I'm a Lyft supervisor, and I make sure their car is clean. I make sure they do a background check, their license, insurance, and the two-way rating system. And I go with them for a 20-minute ride and make sure they can drive.
Okay, good. I'm glad to hear that.
There you go.
And that their car is clean. Cabs need to adapt and overcome. 90% of the reason that people use my service is because stereotype for cabs are true.
Carlos, we got to run. Sorry about that. 512-836-0590, the Todd and Don Show.
The Todd and Don Show is on the air. You can join Todd and Don at 836-0590.
The following takes place between 10 a.m. and 11 a.m.
Now, here are Todd Jeffries and Don Pryor.